Australia, and I think, you know, this is something that would come out in our studies, relies very heavily on the corporate income tax. It's about 20% of total tax revenue in Australia, which is actually higher than most other OECD countries. The average in most other OECD countries is about 10%. So obviously this is an issue that matters a lot for Australia. And these major international corporates and brands, and you know, I'm not picking on any particular multinational. If I say words like Google or Glencore or Apple or Netflix or Vodafone or Starbucks, and the list goes on and on, all these have been sort of apparently revealed in the media to be getting away with it. We had the chief executive officer of.
Wesfarmers,
yeah. Thanks Hannah, yeah. Who came out with the fact that he felt it was grossly unfair that companies like Aldi and Costco, overseas private companies, were able to operate with a lack of transparency in Australia, and therefore there wasn't a level playing field. Coles, Woolies were struggling a little bit to stay up with these international rivals because of that lack of transparency. Is that a real issue?
The Wesfarmers example is an interesting one, and it does sort of at one level illustrate some of the hypocrisy by Australian companies. Wesfarmers, a large listed company which enjoys passing on the benefits of imputation to its own shareholders. The companies which it mentioned are going to be taxed at several levels offshore. At least Wesfarmers acknowledged that there was a lack of transparency which stopped them from properly analysing the issue. I think it's very difficult to conclude that there is something happening in the case of Aldi that would indicate that appropriate tax was not being paid in Europe.
It raises very interesting issues about the role that imputation, and Australia is one of very few countries in the world, New Zealand, Malta, I think I read recently, and one or two others in South America.
I think
America.
Canada perhaps too.
Canada has a form of it, that have full integration, full imputation systems, something that we talk about in the tax of corporations type courses in the master's programme. And it may be that an imputation system whereby you need to pay tax in order to be able to pass it on to your shareholders, keeps them honest in some way, keeps the Australian listed companies honest. I wouldn't say they like to pay tax, who likes to pay tax, but they at least want to pay tax because then they can pass the franking credits on. Is that a fair?
I think that's very fair, and probably some of the clients that I've been working with in respect of their transfer pricing arrangements is that if you're going to pay tax, you'd rather pay it here, where you've got predominantly Australian-based resident shareholders. And that's, I guess, one of the ways in which we're using transfer pricing to reflect the fact that profits should come back to Australia. And a lot of the time, you know, that is genuinely where they do belong. Thanks.